Hey guys, my name is That Quiet Kid, and today we are going to do day 14 of Advent of Cyber 2021. So for day 14, we have Dev Insecure Ops. MacDev, the head of the dev team, sends an alarming email stating that they are unable to update the Best Festival company's external web application. Without this update, no one can view the Best Festival company's plan. The dev team has been using CI/CD server to automatically push out updates to the server, but the CI/CD server has been compromised. Can you help them get this server back? So let's start this machine, and the learning objectives for today's task is understanding of C1CD concept, overview of risks associated with C1CD, having a basic understanding of CI/CD exploitation vector. So what is CI/CD? CI/CD are two terms that will often come up when talking about software development and web ops. Their definitions are pretty straightforward. CI, continuous integration, is the process in which a software code is kept in a central repository. Okay, the changes that are stored in this central repository to avoid ending up with different versions of the same code. So they are all stored, changes are stored in a central repository to avoid the software with different versions. And CD, which is continuous delivery, is the following sometimes integral step of continuous integration model, where code is automatically developed to the deployed to the test pre-production production environment. CD is sometimes used as a acronym for continuous deployment. If you feel the term above don't seem to have clear limits, you are right. CI/CD and the other CD are all parts of DevOps best practices that aim to make code delivery faster and reliable. So let's connect to the TryHackMe VPN. And before that, today I will start using Termux. And this is Termux creating a new session. Dash S is for the session name, and I will name it AOC14. Okay. Now let's connect to the TryHackMe VPN. The command is simple: open VPN and your VPN configuration file and press enter. Major risks to a CI/CD integration are mentioned below. Access security: the increased number of integration points can make access management difficult. Permissions: components are connected with each other and perform their tasks with user accounts. Similar to access security, user permissions should be checked. Keys and secrets: many integrations are done using keys, API keys. These should be secured. And we have default configuration. Some platforms are known to have default credentials and vulnerabilities. User security: user accounts are another successful attack vector often used by cyber criminals. Any user who has access to the source code repository could include a malicious component in the code base and could be included in the deployment application. So the Grinch CI/CD. The Grinch has put his own version of CI/CD pipeline in place. He has used bash script and scheduled jobs to automate the process. Let's dive in. So visiting this site from the browser will show the Grinch is waiting for the loot, but not here. So let's see. Yes, waiting for the loot, but this somewhere else. Okay. So let's view the source code. What do we have here? We're waiting for the loot. We have leemi.png, which is the Grinch picture. So nothing useful here. So let's move on. At this stage, run a derp scan to this. Okay, we have to run a derp scan, which is derp buster. So let's start a new tab using Termux. The command is Control B, and then you enter C, and it will start a new Termux session. Not a new Termux session, but a new tab. So let's go back a directory and cd it to our directory and AOC, and let's start our derp buster. And http://simply-ip and press enter. Okay, let's create another tab as well. And go back here as well, cd into, okay, let's move on. Okay, do we have to answer any of the questions? How many pages did the derp scan find with its default word list? So we will answer this question at the end of the room. because the Durbuston scan will take a long time. And what do we have here? And how many scripts do you see in the home/grinch/scripts folder? So let's see. Okay, looking at the source code, we see something interesting. If we go to this ip/admin page, okay, so let's go to /admin page, and we see this page will update regularly and show the contents of the load folder. So we see def notest.txt, notest.txt, and test.txt and test2.txt. So this actually looks like a output of a ls command. So let's see, what do we have here? Looking at the source code, so let's view the source code, and we see a iframe with a source which is equal to ls.html. so let's go here and we see this, we see this few files, which is like it's kind of doing ls command on a folder and printing it out to the website. Yes, there is a iframe tag that refers to the ls.html page. This page seems suspicious. Close to the output from running the ls command I told earlier. So let's connect to SSH. SSH into the machine. The command is simple. SSH mixkd @the IP and press enter. And it will ask for the password, which is yes. Password is password1. Let's move on. Navigating to the scripts folder and running the ls command will show us the most of the scripts in the folder are not accessible by the mixkd user. So let's see. Have we logged in? Okay, the question was, how many scripts do you see in the home/grinch/scripts folder? So let's see. So have we logged in? It is taking a bit long. So let's move back to our Durbuster result and see. Okay, we have logged in now. So let's complete this first. Okay, so let's cd into that directory, which was this ls-la, and we see all the files are owned by root. Okay, all the files are owned by root, but for this loot.sh we have read write executable for all the users. So this loot.sh can be run, read and executed by any user. So let's see, I think we have all the permissions. Yes, we have read write executable for everyone, but okay, so let's see, we have four files in the scripts folder. We have four scripts in the scripts folder. So let's see. Okay, where am I, let's move up. Okay, the code is simple. The content of loot.sh, so let's cat out this loot.sh, and what do we see? We see that it is ls/home/the grinch/loot to our ls.html, which was this page. So it is printing out the output of ls command on this loot folder and outputting it to this ls.html file. So we can edit this file. Let's use vim. Okay, it is, let's see, what do we have? Okay, the code is simple. It runs the ls command, we know this. The grinch can browse the page from anywhere within the network to see the loot he has accumulated. Clever, this grinch. However, there seems to be a problem regarding the permissions of this continuous integration CI attempt mixkd. Okay, where am I, okay, mixkd can change the contents of loot.sh. yes, we can. We just ran vim on the file, change the code to print out the content of /etc/shadows. So to enter insert mode in vim, we have to press I, and let's see, we want to cat out. Okay, we want to cat out /etc/shadow file, and put a space here. And to exit the insert mode, you have to use the escape key. And after you are out of the insert mode, you have to use colon WQ to exit out of Vim. Okay, so now we will wait for the script to run, and it will output print the output of this etc/shadow file, which contains the hashes of the users. So let's see, have we made changes or not? Yes, we have. We are telling the script to cat out the etc/shadow to this ls.html, and when the script runs, we will see the output of that here. The script has not run yet, so let's give it a bit time and let's move on. We have to change the code in the file to print the contents of etc/shadows. We have done this. This will conclusively prove that this permission misconfiguration not only creates a threat for CI process, but can also be used to escalate our privileges. If you are interested in learning more about privilege escalation techniques, please visit our Linux privilege escalation room. This misconfiguration can be leveraged to read the contents of Grinch's other scripts, because read write executable was only on root.sh and all the other files were owned by root and only he can read it. So through this method we can read the check.sh. So let's see, let's wait for the script to first show us the output of etc/shadow. Yes, it has shown us. Now we can see all the users and their hash. So does that answer any of the question? And what are the five characters following $6G in the Pepper's password hash? Yes, we see Pepper's password hash, and after G we have to copy five letters. Yes, we can. After G, yes, five characters and submit. What is the content of the flag.txt file on the Grinch user's desktop? So we will have to modify the script again. And this time we will, okay, what we were looking for, okay, it's just flag.txt, but before we can also take a look at this script.sh, this check.sh. Okay, we have to first enter the insert mode, then we can edit this file, and it was in home/thegrinch/scripts/ and what was the file name? It was check.sh. I guess we have done everything correct. So let's escape out of this insert mode, use colon WQ to save and quit Vim, and we have, let's run cat on this loot.sh now. Yes, we have modified this script, and have we done everything correct? The folder is home/thegrinch/scripts/ it was check.sh, is it right? check.sh. yes, we are correct. So we'll wait for the script to run and let's see what the script does. Within a couple of minutes, this admin page will be updated to reveal the code of the check.sh script. Okay, so we will wait. Let's see, has it done it yet? Yes, it has. The secret password reminder script v version 1. Response is call this ls.html on the local host and echo its content to temp/check.txt. If grep this remindme.txt, then echo this password to this pass.html file. So let's see, can we access this pass.html file without it? Let's see, pass.html, what do we see? Else are fast. Okay, but we can see. Okay, so what is it trying to tell us? If it finds the file, it prints the Grinch password to an HTML file. Grinch's memory isn't what it used to be. Alternatively, MaxKD could create a file named this in the loot folder and wait for the automation to work its magic. Okay, so it is telling us to create. So let's, before this, let's find out our, where is our flag file. So let's see, we have this loot. No, we have its desktop folder as well. So let's see loot first. I hope it has flag.txt. No, it doesn't. Let's move back. Let's go to desktop. Let's ls and we have flag. Go back, cd into this scripts folder, and let's edit this loot.sh and let's enter insert mode and go back. It was the Grinch slash, I guess, desktop, and the file is flag.txt. So let's use escape button and after that use colon wq to save and exit out of Vim, and let's wait for the script to run and see if it can show us the password, this content of flag.txt file on the Grinch user's desktop. So let's see, let's wait for the file to run. Yes, it has run and we have this flag. So let's, Die Hard is the best Xmas movie. Die Hard, Christmas movie. Okay, so let's, we have answered three questions. So the last one is, how many pages did the derp scan find with its default word list? So let's control B and our derp session is at 1, so type enter after that and we are in. It's found only one till, so let's read a bit more. Lessons learned, this CICD simulation aimed to help showcase major types of vulnerabilities that are often seen in CI/CD automation. A locally installed Jenkins application can have an unpatched component deployed for various operational reasons. However, it is rare that a critical vulnerability remains unpatched for an extended period of time on infrastructure managed by a cloud server provider such as Amazon, Azure, or Google. This is the main reason you will more often see vulnerabilities being a result of improper access management. In the above example, we have seen folder permissions that were too lax, we see file permissions were misconfigured, improper key protection, and we have installation was not secure. So this Durbuster scan will take a lot of time, so I have already ran it and I will show you the output of this Durbuster. So as you can see that, let me enter, to move up in Termux, you have to type Control B and this bracket, and let's move up. And I will show you, this was the same command that I used, Durbuster. HTTP IP is changed, and we see it has found two files yet, and when I ran it, it found the four files, which was admin, index.html, server status, and worries. So it has found four pages. So let's press enter, and so that completes our day 14 of Advent of Cyber 2021, and thank you for watching.